We now move on to the order of business. I'm sorry, leave the speeches, my apologies. You have me flustered there. Leader speeches.
Thank you, Kion Corlett. Taoiseach, 4 years ago, Deputy Michael McGrath tabled and published legislation proposing to set up an independent mortgage resolution office, essentially to provide a proper intermediary force between the banks and people in mortgage distress, and to ensure that the banks would not have a veto over resolution of mortgage arrears and agreements. And essentially you ignored it. And month after month since then, you have ignored pleas from the opposition to change the relationship between the banks and people in mortgage arrears, and essentially to change the veto that the banks have over any debt resolution agreement that comes from any process. And now we know, Taoiseach, that there's been up to 586 repossessions since January. And that's 500% increase on this time last year in terms of house repossessions. And the majority of these are homes, not investment properties. And you will recall, Taoiseach, that it was government legislation in 2013 circumventing the Dunn judgment that allowed the repossession train to start, that commenced essentially the repossession train. And research has already shown that 1,000 homes have actually been repossessed. It's now estimated that there's up to 8,000 civil bills before the Circuit Court in relation to repossessions. So, Taoiseach, we are facing a major crisis because of government inaction in relation to people in mortgage arrears and the anxiety and the stress that has happened as a result. And that's on top of the homelessness crisis that we have and the appalling fact that up to 1,000 children are in emergency accommodation in this city.
Question, please. Thank you.
And what I want to put to you, Taoiseach, is this. You have ignored the genuine calls on this side for an ending to the bank veto and various legislative propositions that we have put. When are you going to, Taoiseach, remove the veto that the banks currently have in relation to debt resolution mechanisms? The Personal Insolvency Act has been very ineffective and has failed. We're hearing via the media, leaks and so on like that, that something's going to happen.
Thank
4 years from the time that Deputy McGrath first tabled a private member's legislation, which, if the government had accepted, would have paved the way, I think, for a far more reasonable approach to this issue. It's a shocking indictment of what you've been doing over the last 4 years.
Thanks, Ian Cole. We've dealt with this on a number of occasions already. The number of mortgage accounts in arrears, that is, all arrears past one day due, stood at 84,717 at the end of February this year, and that's a decline of over 3,000 compared to the January 2015 figure. The total number of mortgage accounts that have been restructured stood at 106,402 at the end of February. That means that people were able to sit down, discuss the distress of the mortgage involved, and in 106,402 cases, a solution, a sustainable solution for the future was arrived at. So the number of mortgage accounts in arrears of greater than 90 days continues to fall, decreasing by 1,730 to 59,138. It was a decrease of 482 mortgage accounts in arrears of greater than 720 days, which stood at 28,900 at the end of this year. The numbers, Deputy Martin, in very long-term arrears is a matter for major concern. It's important to note that the latest central bank data showed the number in over 720 days drop for the banks in quarter four 2014 for the first time. Now, the government wants the maximum number of mortgage holders in very long-term arrears to be able to afford their mortgage, to retain ownership of their houses where they can afford it, and if they cannot, to have a viable and an easy accessible option or options available to either stay in the house or to have access to alternative housing. You mentioned repossessions. The government does not see repossessions as a policy solution, and every action that has been taken since coming to office has been designed to ensure that the maximum number of people can and families can continue to live in their houses. According to the last central bank report in the last quarter of last year, of the 429 properties that were taken into possession by the banks, less than a third, or 123, were repossessed as a result of a court order, while the remaining two-thirds were voluntarily surrendered or were abandoned. So there have been a lot of coverage, as you know, of increases in civil bills being lodged by financial institutions. It's important to say that the commencement of the court process is not a signal or an end in itself that repossession will occur. The Minister for Finance has stated that it may often be the case that that process prompts borrowers to re-engage with the lender in the first place to find a solution. And often these cases are adjourned. I listened to a commentary from actual cases recently on the news that allows both parties time to find a solution and to remove the bank and the borrower from the legal process. It is fair to say, Deputy, that while there are a number of options available, such as MABS or the Insolvency Agency, all of these do not work in a number of cases, Account Corla. And so the government have committed to bringing forward a number of further solutions that will deal with the question of really distressed mortgages, where the option can be had for another alternative in respect of those borrowers, so that in the vast majority of cases, the option will be there for that family or that tenant to remain in the house following a number of solutions. So the point about the veto that you mentioned, Deputy Martin, and that's an issue that in respect of further options be brought forward by government next week, I will deal with cases where there are serious distress.
Thank you.
They're outside the scope of the discussions that have taken place, the over 100,000 sorted out, but still the concern that we have about long-term mortgage indebtedness there in those cases.
Taoiseach, I didn't just mention repossessions and I didn't just mention bank veto. I made them the main part of the question that I put to you. And you choose to ignore them until the very, very end of your reply. And the statistics yesterday, Taoiseach, show that there was over 586 repossessions since January, and 383 of those were homes. Okay, Taoiseach. We know from research by Professor Seamus Coffey in UCC that there's been 1,000 court-enforced repossessions has taken place already. And we know that there's 8,000 civil bills in before the courts as we speak. And it's not good enough to say, should they only take you to court to bring you along to the process and to engage? They take you to court because they load the trigger, Taoiseach, and they can pull the trigger whenever they want to. And it puts the person who holds the mortgage in an impossible position, causes enormous distress and anxiety. And I've dealt with cases who had engaged.
Thank you.
And all the time you take the bank's side, and the Minister of Finance does as well. And you're at it again today.
Thank you, Chair.
Basically saying, we'll bring them to court because they haven't engaged before then. An awful lot of people engage before they ever get any legal letters, Taoiseach. But they still get the legal letters. And they still have all the anxiety that goes with that.
Question, please. Thank you.
Now, the question I put to you, Taoiseach, for 4 years you've been asked to end the veto that the banks have over this entire process. Your personal solvency practitioners, in terms of that bill, didn't work. And you called them in because you wanted to hear from them about 6 months ago. So, Taoiseach, something has to happen to change the status quo.
Thank you.
Are you going to change the veto that the banks have over the entire process? Yes or no?
Taoiseach. I reject your assertion that the government continually take the side of the banks. That's entirely false. And it's beneath you to actually say that. But be that as it may, populist line. I'd remind you above all people that when you speak of 4 years ago, the mess that you left behind was the cause of all of this. And people should not be allowed to forget that. And when you're down in Carlow and Kilkenny, you should tell them that your government put $34 billion into Anglo-Irish Bank, and that money is lost, and you were the cause of losing it. And part of that was responsible for the total collapse of the construction sector. The total collapse of it, which is dealing with the questions that Deputy Cowan was asking of Minister Coffey just before I came in here. Now, the question here, you asked me, and I reject your assertion about being any advocate for the banks. My comments right along in respect of banks and the way they've treated people is not satisfactory. But it requires in the 109,000 cases, Deputy Martin, that were sorted out, that people were able to sit across the table and work out an agreed solution to those cases where mortgage distress applied. Now, I said to you, the government will bring in next week a number of further options to deal with these distress cases, in particular cases that are in long-term arrears, such as I pointed out. I'm not going to give you the details of those here. The government will announce them next week, Deputy. Thank you.